Hi there, Serdar Yagulalp here for InfoWorld at IDG. Today in SmartPython, I'll be demonstrating some of the useful new features in the just-released Python 3.9. Now, whenever a new version of Python is released, there's typically two big types of changes. The first are things under the hood that most people never encounter, like performance improvements. The second are things like changes to the language itself, new features or modifications to existing features that make writing Python programs easier and more powerful. So with this video, I'm going to concentrate on the second category of new features. First up, we have a new operator for dictionaries called the union operator. Now, one common scenario with dictionaries is to take two or more of them and merge the contents of them. And typically you do this with the update method on a dictionary, as seen in this example. But one problem with update is that it modifies the dictionary in place. Sometimes you want to create a new dictionary that's a merger of two old ones, and you want to leave the existing ones intact. So the union operator in 3.9 lets you do this. If I have these two dictionaries, and I merge them this way, the contents of the dict on the left are merged with the contents of the dict on the right, and then a new dictionary is generated from the merger of the two. Note that the mergers do not include values, they only include keys. If I have dictionaries themselves as the values, they aren't merged. They will simply replace each other. If you want to perform recursive merging of dictionaries where the values are themselves merged as well, you'll have to write something like that by hand. Next up, we have the remove prefix and remove suffix string methods. These help fill out a common scenario that until now didn't really have a convenient way to be done in Python. If I have a string that starts or ends with some particular substring, I can remove that easily from the start or end of the string without needing to mess with string slices. This example here shows how I might try to do this in an earlier version of Python. It's not too difficult, but I'd really rather have this functionality as a native string method. And as you can see here, the Python 3.9 version of the same functionality does exactly that. I don't have to call a function to remove prefixes or suffixes. It's built right into the way strings behave. Third and finally are some additions to the way type hinting works in Python. Now, type hints are a way to annotate variables, functions, and methods in Python with indications about the types of all of the objects involved. They're optional, they're not enforced at runtime, but they're useful, especially in large projects, and they make it easier for Python linting tools to detect errors. Python 3.9 adds a couple of new type hinting enhancements. One is that for collections, like lists, you don't need to import anything from the typing module to annotate them with the types of objects that they contain. For instance, in this example, I have a function that takes a dictionary, whose keys are strings and whose values are integers, and which returns integers. I can specify the dictionary's internal types directly. I don't have to perform any imports from typing to do that. Now note that if I try to run this code as is in Python 3.8, it won't work because the annotations require imports from typing to be recognized as legal syntax. But if I switch to the Python 3.9 interpreter, it runs fine. Just so you have an idea of what this looks like in Python 3.8, here's a version of the same script using typing as an import. Note that dict is imported with a capital D so that it doesn't conflict with the actual original definition of dict. But again, in Python 3.9, you don't have to go through any of this. You can just use dict directly. That's it for this video. If you liked it, leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel on YouTube. And for more Python tips, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.